Hi, in this video I want to talk about some myths about gemstones. I come across people, those who come to me and ask that they want to wear 5 carat, 7 carat gemstones. And when I ask them, why you are so particular about how many carats you are supposed to wear, then they tell me that some astrologer told them that as per the body weight it is given. I have not found an astrologer anywhere in the old scriptures talking about this kind of relation between your body weight and the gemstone weight. It really does not matter how many carats gemstone you wear. What matters is that the gemstones should consist of the chemicals which is supposed to consist. For example, if you are wearing a yellow sapphire, it should consist of aluminum oxide. If you are wearing a blue sapphire, it should consist of aluminum oxide, titanium and iron. If you are wearing an emerald, it should have beryllium, silicon and aluminum. The chemical composition is of more importance than the weight of the gemstone. Because the weight of the gemstones as it goes up, the prices goes up very high, because the gemstone prices goes up geometrically, not arithmetically. Like I explained in the one video, if it is 1 carat, supposing it is 25,000, 3 carat does not mean 75,000 rupees, it may be 2 lakhs, 3 lakhs. It's very costly. Natural gemstones are always very costly. Natural gemstones, another thing people come to me and ask me, and there is some crack, there is some lining there inside the gemstone. I don't think you should worry about it. Because if you are talking about the chemical composition, then how does it matter if there are some kind of elements which you are being seen inside the gemstone? Gemstones are natural products. It is dug out from the earth, beneath the earth. And obviously you cannot expect that the gemstone will be absolutely clean and clear unless it is heated and treated. It has been treated by artificial colors, it has been heated to make it sparkle, then obviously it will be very clean. So artificial or man-made gemstones are always very neat, very clean and looks more beautiful than natural ones. Keep this in mind that it is not the weight, it is not the look, it is not the shape, it is not the so-called flaws in the gemstones which matters. What matters is that it should consist of the chemicals which are supposed to consist. Because the gemstones, they release negative ions of the chemical compositions of which it is made of. These negative ions, they interact with the electrolytes in our blood plasma, and that is how they work. So wasting money to buy stones which are very costly are of no use. Those are for jewelry purpose, show purpose, and to show off that you are wearing a stone which is very costly. You should go for a stone which is in sync with your body frequency. You see, your body has a frequency and each gemstone has a frequency. So what you should do, that you should get your body frequency and the gemstone frequency checked. But that's what we do at Udra Center with a digital scanner, which is DNA based. We check out your body frequency, check out the frequency of the stone, and we find out the synchronicity between your body frequency and the gemstone frequency. That is more important than going for the looks and the weight. That is what I have been practicing and following, and I find good results from the procedure which I follow. So I want to make you aware that don't run after very costly gemstones. If you have money, you want to wear, you want to show off, there's no problem, you can. But majority of the people, they find it difficult to buy very costly gemstones. So I always encourage people to don't get guided by this how many carats and what the look and what the shape of the gemstones. You just go for those gemstones which has these chemical compositions, and it will definitely work for you. And also I have told you in the past videos that must get your astrological chart analyzed so that you know which gemstone you should not wear. Any graha, any energy which is against you, which is not good for you, never wear that gemstone. If the Brihaspati is not good for you, never wear a yellow sapphire. If the Saturn is not good for you, never wear a blue sapphire. And if the Buddha graha, the Mercury is not good for you, never wear a emerald. It will harm you. For that, you can use Rudraksh in lieu. because Rudraksh will balance those negative energies and convert those negative energy to positive ones, because energy cannot be created or destroyed, but energy can be converted. That is what I believe, I profess and advise. This is Wing Commander Santosh Sharmaa. Namaskar.